We have over 900 million dogs in our world today, and many of which are homeless, abused, and deprived of basic necessities such as food, water, and shelter. We see these homeless dogs everywhere around us, everywhere we go, especially on the street. And in our cars, we pass by them and have the slightest empathy for them, yet we do not seem to take any action for these poor creatures. We were given the greatest opportunity in gaining insights of the story of the homeless lives of these dogs through interviewing one of the owners of the Paws Animal Shelter, which we helped out and visited. Sadly, videos were not permissible for this interview. Instead, here are a few pictures showing the activities that we did during our time helping out at Paws for the past 2 days.
So, are there enough funds given to help out the shelters?
Well, it is an area that we are always struggling with. Besides space constraints, financial is a huge thing. We are definitely not well off as a non-profit organization. Of course, we do get by. Of course, we always need help in this side, when it comes to finances, yes.
So, in terms of finance, where do you get the main funds from?
So the shelter and all the costs involved are entirely funded by generous donations of the public, as well as proceeds from charitable events.
So where did the animals that are sheltered here mostly come from?
A lot of them come from owners surrendered pets. The next would be rescued strays, where people find stray animals outside and they bring them here because they, for any reason, are unable to keep the animal or unable to find adopters for the animals, so they send them here. The third one would be from local council. MBPJ sends animals here, MBSA occasionally.
So how long have you been working here for?
About a year and a half.
And, like, just from your experience, can you tell us about, like, I don't know, maybe what you have learned from working here with the animals or anything like that?
Well, one thing I've learned is we need to raise more awareness about pet responsibility, because a lot of people still think pets are something that is disposable. You know, if they feel like having a pet, to their whims and fancies, they get a pet. But they do not understand that it is actually a lifelong responsibility.
So, aside from that, does the government help out with shelters like these in Malaysia?
In the larger picture, no. No. Unfortunately. So I think animal welfare is something where the government should pay more attention to.
Mm-hmm.
There should be more help from the government.
Besides the advice you gave just now about the pets and stuff, do you have any other advice to society?
Neutering your pets, that's a very important one, because you may keep your pet at home and you don't want to neuter it, but if your animal ever escapes, say you open the gate and it runs out, it may meet a stray animal, may cause breeding, and breeding is an exponential problem. You know, it can be 6 this time, but those 6 puppies or kittens can then breed 36.
Yeah.
And then the number grows way faster than we can control it. So neutering your pets is a very important thing. Anyway, there are a lot of medical benefits to neutering your pets. Reduces the likelihood of cancer. Makes them more docile in temperament. Males, less territorial marking.
Yeah.
So there are actually no downsides to littering at all.
So, like, let's say if an animal has been here like for a really long time and no one adopts them, do you guys like
this? If we face serious overcrowding issue, yes, we do have to select very, very old dogs, dogs that are very, very sickly, dogs that show signs of aggression. Sometimes they can over time. Unfortunately, we have to.
So, to make sure it goes to the right owner, do you guys like what do you guys do to make sure that this is the right owner that we can give it to?
Well, as stated on our website, we have to conduct an informal interview with the potential owner.
Uh-huh.
Just to find out if that person suits the animal.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your
Thanks. Thank you.
Volunteering at Paul for the past 2 days has been very beneficial to me in many ways. I learned that animals are a very important part of our lives, not just humans, and that people need to be more aware of that. I also learned that I also learned to appreciate the lives of these homeless animals and honestly be very grateful to have volunteers, like people who work at PAWS, to be able to help out these precious animals. For myself, I have a dog at home, and when I compare this lifestyle to the way these animals are at here, it is nothing in comparison to that. Perhaps I may be wrong in saying that perhaps my dog lives in a more luxurious lifestyle compared to the dogs here, but it really got me to appreciate how, you know, it doesn't matter if you live in a dog
since I'm young, but I've never adopted a dog before because my parents didn't like it. So yeah, so it's a good experience if you don't have any like animals at house, or even if you do have one, you can always come by and help out with the volunteering work.
It's like 500, something like that. So, yeah, it's a real option.